Hi guys, in this hands-on, we're going to go into the management console and we're going to look at how we can use AWS Systems Manager to manage EC2 instances. The first thing I want to do is create an IAM role. Now, the reason for that is there's two things we need to be able to manage our instances with Systems Manager. The first one is the agent, and that's going to be already installed on the AMI we use. And then there's a role, and the role will give the EC2 instance the permissions it needs to talk to Systems Manager. So I'm going to create role. It's going to be for EC2 so that EC2 can actually call Systems Manager. And for policy, if we just search for SSM, we'll find this policy here. And SSM comes from an older name for Systems Manager. So we can select this policy. And if you want to look at the policy, you'll see that it has lots of permissions to Systems Manager. So with the policy selected, I'm going to click on Next, click on Review, and I'm actually going to call it the same name as the policy. So that's Amazon EC2 role for SSM. And let's create the role. So we've got our role created. Now we need to go to EC2 and launch an instance. In EC2, I'm going to launch an instance. Now the Amazon Linux 2 AMI already comes with the SSM agent, as well as the Windows option here as well. So we can choose either one of these. Let's choose the Windows option to make things a little bit different. So I'm going to choose the Windows Server 2019 base. Once selected, I'm going to use T2 Micro, and then I need to make sure that I use my role. So that's the Amazon EC2 role for SSM. With that selected, let's click on Next. Come through to Security Group, choose our web access, and then we'll launch our instance. So the instance is launching. It has the permissions it needs for Systems Manager, and it has the agent pre-installed on it. So that should be everything we need. We can now go to Systems Manager, and within a few minutes, we should start seeing some information populated. Now in Systems Manager, you'll probably get put on the quick setup page when you first arrive. And all you have to do there is just click on create, and it will automatically have this host management option. You click on next and essentially just finish. You don't have to change any settings. And then you'll have this host management configuration type here. So now it will take a few minutes for our instance to actually report information. But when it does, we should be able to find some information about its inventory under the Node Management Inventory tab here. After a few minutes, I can see that a small amount of information has been populated. We now know that we have the Windows operating system version here, and some more information may come soon. Now, what I want to do is go down to Documents, and under Documents, here we have all of these documents we can use with Run Command and Automation. Now, I'm just going to search for the word stop. And it's filtered the list of results, and I've got this option here to stop an EC2 instance. And in the document configuration, we can see that it applies to Windows as well as Linux and macOS, so that's good. And what I want to do is click Execute Automation. There's various options here. I'm going to leave it on Simple Execution. And then for Instance ID, I'm going to flick this little box here, and we can see our instance. Now, often you can search by tags as well, which is a good way to actually use automation. So with our instance selected, I'm going to click on execute, and hopefully that should stop our EC2 instance because we now have it under management control. It has the agent, and so all we need to do is actually run this command from Systems Manager, and we can see that this is being executed. It's in progress, and back on EC2 here, I've just refresh my page, and it's this bottom instance here. We can see it's in the stopping state now. And once the instance is fully stopped, we get a success message. So now, if we want to start it up again, we can go back to Documents, search for Start, and Start EC2 Instance is the one we want. So now we'll just execute this automation, again, choosing the instance we have. And what we want to do here is show all instances because it's in a stop state. And so this is the instance, the one I just stopped. We can see it has the instance profile attached to it. So then let's click on execute. It's been initiated. And back in EC2, if I click on refresh, I've now got a pending, so that's starting back up again. So that's a very simple demonstration of how to use Systems Manager. Now, as you can see, there's lots more documents in there. You can do things like scan for patches and install patches and various other activities as well. And that's it for this hands-on lesson. So all I need to do to clean up is just terminate my EC2 instance, and there's nothing else that we created that's going to cost us any money.